Bagnaia è campione del mondo con la Ducati. È campione del mondo. Sono campioni del mondo.
When I signed for Ducati, was my goal, was my dream, and also at home I was thinking sometimes if I had the good choice, the good team for my future. And then I was always saying, this is the good thing, this is the dream, and if I was able to win the title with this bike, with this team, for sure have a different taste.
The long wait is over. 15 years of hurt and over for Ducati. They are world champions for the first time since 2007.
I was feeling all this pressure, all this weight behind me. And it wasn't easy, but was also motivation to achieve this goal. I'm very proud of my world team, so it's incredible for us.
Pecco Bagnaia is crowned 2022 MotoGP World Champion. One of the greatest comebacks in Grand Prix racing is complete. Pecco Bagnaia has gone down, and surely that is World Championship hopes extinguished permanently now for Pecco Bagnaia.
91 points were a lot, but I was thinking about the potential we had. I was thinking that I was not that type of rider to have this kind of up and down. I was have a better consideration of myself. I was thinking that I was able to be competitive, to fight for the title. I was thinking that I had the potential to be champion. I think I used the determination, the ambition to be there, to be fighting for it. Just understanding that I was a rider able to do it. And in the same moment I start thinking on it, the same moment I start thinking to be very competitive, I start working in a different way, trying to work from the FP1 on just on the race pace, just on new starts, and this has helped me a lot to be more focused in the situation of the race. That way it helped me to start winning.
7 days ago in the Sachsen Ring, Dutch TT winner in 2022 is Pecco Bagnaia.
Bagnaia c'è! E vince il Gran Premio d'Inghilterra! Bagnaia! Desmo Pecco c'è!
You start feeling that you are unbeatable, and it's something that is not so good to say, but when I finished second in Aragon, I was angry. You don't have the fifth win in a row.
Bagnaia, the best of British at Silverstone, takes a famous win here.
An understandably cross Fabio Quartararo, who thought a victory was possible.
Pecco Bagnaia, that wins an absolute thriller here in Misano.
Fabio Quartararo, damage limitation to a certain extent.
Maybe Fabio was too defensive in that part of the championship. I don't know if I put so much pressure on them, but for sure something have changed, because looking at the first part of the season, they were more constant, and in the second part of the season, they've started to struggle a bit more.
Welcome back to the Riccardo Tormo circuit. It's time to crown a MotoGP World Champion. It's lights out, full throttle, and we're underway.
I was in a better situation than Fabio, easier for sure, because he had to win and I had to finish for 15 if he wanted to win the championship. But in this kind of situation, it's very easy to commit mistakes.
Oh. Running wide there, Quartararo coming out of turn number one.
Oh, contact!
Big contact! This is incredible action here in MotoGP. Side by side, leaning on each other again, aren't they? They've already had contact.
Three laps to go. I see that Fabio was in P4. After the jet crash, and I was ninth, so I was knowing that was enough to be champion. Then in the last lap when I crossed the finish line, I saw in my pit board that I was the 2022 world champion.
Pecco Bagnaia will be crowned 2022 MotoGP world champion.
In this moment, I'm not understanding what we did, what we achieved. So maybe when I will be back home, I will understand it. Looking at all the media, all the videos, so it will be a different story.
Pecco, go free, vola libero.